Hey guys, this is HLC, also known as Sergeant First Class Long, and this is the Himars. The M142 Himars, or High Mobility Artillery Rocket System. This American-developed, lightweight rocket artillery system, well, think about it like a jack-in-the-box. The longer you keep cranking that handle, sooner or later, surprise, you've got rockets. Seated atop an up-armored FMTV chassis. FMTV stands for Family of Medium Tactical Vehicle Chassis, made by Oshkosh. This thing has a range of 300 miles with a 54-gallon tank. The 5-ton 6x6 chassis allows it to ford through any kind of different types of terrain. Sand, mud, snow, and up to 40 inches of water. Each rocket pod is capable of holding 6 rockets or 1 missile behind all 6 of these pods. Between the US and their allies, they have over 20 different types of munitions. Now these range from GPS aided to GPS guided. What's the difference between aided and guided? Well, GPS aided is more of a to whom it may concern dear grid square. GPS guided is how you choose which room on which floor of which building you want to introduce to the most aggressive form of extreme makeover home edition you've ever seen. One of the things that the HIMARS doesn't really use anymore is this. DPICM, DPICM, Dual Purpose Improved Conventional Munition. One of those rockets would have over 500 of these, which is a shape charge. It would fall out, the wind would catch this little ribbon, it would arm, and as it hit on top of something, kaboom. These could penetrate up to 4 inches of top armor on top of an enemy tank. Now the United States stopped using these, not because they're a war crime, but because they had a 2% fail rate. That's right, America will get rid of something that is 98% effective because it's not effective enough. One of the cluster munitions that is still in use is the APAM, or anti-personnel or anti-material. You had a missile full of about 300 of these that would spread out across an area, and this is an angry baseball filled with explosives. So naturally, you can imagine what that did. One of the other configurations is the alternate warhead. It has over 160,000 of varying sizes of tungsten ball bearings that when an airburst configuration can take anything in a 50-meter radius with one rocket and turn its pronouns into past tense. Each of these rockets are about 13 feet long, and in that 13 feet, they're leaving this canister at about Mach 2. But unlike similar systems employed throughout the world, you don't have to get out of this and hide at a safe distance. A positive air system allowing filtered air to pressurize the cab keeps you safe inside so you can fire the mission, pack up, and move faster than anything else on the market. In the HIMARS, the gunner sits here. This is the gunner's display unit. After they put in all of their location data, what they're trying to shoot, and where they're trying to shoot it at, it's as simple as arm and fire, and you can empty the rocket pod in 26 seconds. Inputs from the gunner's display unit get input here into the launcher interface unit. This is the brains of the system. It takes those inputs and positions the system ready to fire the missiles. This is the hydraulic manifold, similar to things you might see on like a track hoe or a backhoe. Once the system decides where it needs to go, this manifold pushes hydraulic power to where it needs to go to turn the system and operate it effectively. This is the position and navigation unit. Once you get your GPS data, which happens up in the cab, filtered back here, it has 3 ring laser gyros, which measure pitch, yaw, and roll of the system to make sure that your shots are effectively hitting their targets. This is the weapons interface unit. While every other part of this system is talking to the launcher, pointing it, making sure its roll and cross roll is correct, this is speaking directly to the warhead. It's deciding exactly how dead you want your target to be. You want airburst? It can do it. You want it to hit the ground and explode? It can do it. The HIMARS has the ability to load itself, which means in a matter of about 5 minutes, it can drop a pod, pick up a new one, and reload itself. So in about the time it would take the enemy to make 2 hot pockets, you can get another pod on and be raining hate. So whether you're talking the M142 HIMARS or the M270 MLRS or multiple launch rocket system, countries across the world can't wait to get their hands on American rocket artillery. We'll talk about that one another time.